And now invite the room proposals and amendments. Is there a second? Move that.
So moved.
And is there a second then? Okay. Okay, we'll ask you, any, all those in favour? Any votes against? So that's been agreed. And finally, number 4, and I'd like the legal counsel to move the revision of the constitutional arrangements for Wirral Park Open Discipline.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I now invite the leader of the council to move the approval of the revision of the constitutional arrangements for Wirral Partnership Homes trading as Magenta, living to enable a proposed group structure.
So moved.
A second then? All those for? Any against?
The different charge in the bin taxes has exacerbated those people are unable to save money if not unable to access the service online. That motion, Mr. Mayor, was passed unanimously, and all members expressed their concerns on readiness to help the issue develop. And I am aware that some members are very active as IT champions, potentially more than particularly active to help as many people who are significantly excluded. But frankly, the question remains, how does the initial decision to charge people a different amount based on whether they have access to the internet or not fit into the sentiments of that notice of motion that was passed by the council? Mr. Mayor, I ask for a breakdown of how people subscribe by board, made this available to the cabinet at the time. I'm looking at the at the figures, Rebecca and Tramia, of those who subscribed on offline, 25% of those who access that service in Rebecca and Tramia have to pay the additional money, the same as Sullivan. For instance, St. James, Miss Garden, Wallasey, and Sullivan, Wallasey, are in the range of 17 to 19% of those residents that have access to the service have not been so online. And I think having heard those board names, Mr. Mayor, members will recognise those names as correlating almost exactly to those communities that are recognised by us in different ways as being amongst the most deprived. I do welcome from the cabinet members' report earlier the fact that the Garden Waste Commercial Manager is exploring alternatives for residents who don't subscribe online, such as payments and also by automating telephone lines, etc. So that's a welcome development. So I'd just like to check how the cabinet member responds, whether that will mean that those people will be able to pay for a lower rate if they use those channels of subscription. The comments, members, I'm not sure what it is, but you know, it gives me an opportunity to whittle about the internet, I'm sure. I think what I'm looking to do is try to seek the support of the council to refer the matter back to the cabinet to look again at the fairness of charging different amounts. It is the only council service that operates in digital divide in this way. It doesn't correlate to the things that we've said and the votes that we've taken in the past when we talk about digital exclusion. I would invite the council or invite the cabinet member or public to look again at the issue. There's not a great deal of money, but most people do it online. We are obviously looking at people who are generally excluded from this. It might not be something that you can do partway through a year, but certainly when you look at it next week, I would ask that that we do away with the digital divide and allow people to subscribe at the lower rate. I hasten to add by whatever means are most convenient for them, and that will impact most strongly.